Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSE 2018. The given question is, in an entity relationship model, suppose, okay, so this is also a diagrammatical question, right? Yes, suppose R is a many to one relation. Okay, so we are having a relation R, which is many to one relation entity set E1 to E2. So E1 to E2. Okay, assume that E1 and E2 participate totally in R. So they are saying both of them participate totally. Okay, and they are saying, okay, and that the cardinality of E1 is greater than cardinality of E2. So if this count is N, this count is M, they are saying N is always greater than M. They are not saying greater than or equal to, they are clearly saying it is greater than, that's it, right? Yes. So now they are asking which one of the following is true about R. Okay, so I think for easy understanding, let us write a small example, guys. Okay, so when it comes to many to one relation, so what is the pattern, guys? So if A, B, C, D are here, so here they told it should be greater. So A, B, C, D, E. So let us assume 1, 2, 3 here. So as it is a many to one relation, okay, so on this side you will see many relations, right? Yes, or you can assume in the reverse way also, like one to many relation from this side. So one to many, in one to many, what is the case, guys? So this one particular guy will be mapped to multiple people, right? Yes, so you can assume in this way, right? Yes, so this is, I think this will be the simple case, right? Yes, of many to one. So here these people are connected to many items, so many to one, got it? Yes, so anyway, but understand the example, guys, that's it. So from this diagram, if you are able to draw this example, it will be really easy for you to analyze the answer, guys, got it? Yes, so now what are they asking? So they are asking for a true statement. Okay, so option A says that every entity in E1 is associated with exactly one entity in E2. So A is mapped to 1, B is mapped to 1, C is mapped to 2, D is mapped to 3. So I find nothing issue in this, guys, because that example is exactly matching our thing. So option B says that some entities in E1 is associated with more than one. Absolutely wrong, because it is saying one people is mapped to two people here. But that is wrong because we are talking about many to one, right? Yes. So now moving on to option C. Option C says that every entity in E2 is associated with exactly one entity. So is it mapped to exactly one entity? No, here one is mapped to two entities. The reason why it is because here they clearly told that it is greater. So this option is wrong. Okay, moving on to option D. Option D says that every entity in E2 is associated with at most one entity. So here they told exactly one, here they are saying at most. So at most means what, guys? So there could be zero relations or one relation, but here I am finding two relations. So hence this is also wrong. So the most appropriate answer is A, guys. Got it? Yes. So the thing for this question is, if you are able to draw the diagram and if you are able to write the example, you are going to get the mark, guys. That's it. So that is the reason why practice these examples like many to one and one to many, because that's the only thing which students confuse, right? Yes. Okay. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Okay. Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.